So let's picture this common scenario. You're using Ocean WP to create great looking websites, and you're using Elementor or Elementor Pro to create really good looking pages and have tons of control, but you want to make changes that are kind of outside the scope of what they can do. Well, you're normally reliant upon hand coding the CSS to get stuck in and fine tune and tweak various different things. But let's just say you don't have the time, the skills, or the knowledge to be able to do some of the things you want. Well, in this video, I'm going to show you one plugin that really does open up a ton of possibilities. We're going to jump in and take a look at that plugin right now. So in today's video, we're going to be taking a look at CSS Hero and how we can use that in conjunction with Ocean WP and Elementor Pro to give us even more control and flexibility over how we create and style our websites. So I'm Paul C and welcome to WPTuts, where I show you how to create beautiful WordPress websites without all the technical jargon. If this is your first time on the channel, please consider subscribing and clicking the bell icon to be notified of our weekly new content as soon as it's added to the channel. Okay, so CSS Hero, what exactly is it? What does it do? Well, it's a plugin for WordPress that gives us a control panel that allows us to get in and fine-tune and tweak the CSS on any page, any element, and then we can save that independent of the theme, the plugins you're using on there, any sort of page creators like Visual Composer or Elementor. It's completely independent, so it opens up a ton of options. So let's just jump into WordPress and let me show you some of the benefits of working with CSS Hero. So if we take a look at the site we're working with, this is a site that I've set up using Ocean WP and Elementor Pro. Nothing special. I've shown you this site previously. Your typical kind of layout on there. So we can get in and we can fine tune and control a lot of this, but there are various different aspects you don't necessarily have an easy time controlling. For example, if we jump over to the shop section, if we want to do things like control these buttons, they're not necessarily part of the theme. You may want to have different things controlled and styled that are outside the scope of what you can do with that. Well, with CSS Hero, we can get really creative. Now, to work with it, it works very much like the customizer inside WordPress. So you can see if I jump over, once I've got it installed, I've now got Edit with CSS Hero. Once I click on that, it's going to open up what looks like a typical sort of composer page, or customizer page, but it's all working with CSS Hero. So you should be pretty much accustomed to it. We've got a simple bar across the top, and it allows us to do various different things. We can switch between the two different modes where we can actually select an item on the page, and then we can access the CSS for that. Alternatively, if you want to jump to different pages, we can switch over to the navigation option. That disables sort of CSS Hero's sort of selection options and allows us to go through then and choose different pages. So if I want to jump over to the shop, for example, I can click on shop, jump over to that, jump into a product, for example, switch back over to the select mode, and now I can start selecting elements. I'm not going to go over too much in detail because I've already covered how you use this. I just want to show you how quick and easy it is to use in conjunction with these. Now, I'll give you the link in the description below so you can check out the other video on this where I go into a lot more detail. I'll also pop it up in the top corner now so you can click there and take a look later on. So you can see as we mouse over anything, we now start to get selectors telling us what it is we can actually go through and adjust. So for example, let's just say I want to style this button differently. You can see when I mouse over, I get all the different CSS selectors, which is great, but if you have no knowledge or understanding or care for this, you could just ignore it, click the button, and now on the left-hand side, we've got all the things we can do to control the way that looks. So you can see it's broken down pretty simple and straightforward. We've got backgrounds, typography, borders, and so on. We switch between properties and snippets, and underneath, you can see we've also got some information about the actual CSS selector that we've got sort of chosen, we've picked. Now, all I need to do is come down and say I want to do something with the border radius. I can click on that. That opens up all the options that are specific to the border radius. So let's just say that for this, I want to go through and I want to sort of just create a more interesting looking button. So we'll grab the top sort of left radius. We'll set that to a value of 15 and the bottom right corner radius, set that to a value of 15. And we've quickly and easily created a more interesting looking button, all done through CSS. You can also see the CSS code is now shown underneath for the alterations we've made. So we've seen the selector and the actual code. If I wanted to, I could easily come in and start adding more in this so I can manually adjust and create different CSS on top of what CSS Hero can do. So already pretty cool. If I click on save and publish, it doesn't care what theme I'm using or anything else because it's just creating its own CSS coding that'll override anything that's currently set up. So we just jump over back over to our test page and we come into a product. You'll see now that our button is already taken on the shape and the form that we've set up through using CSS Hero. So pretty cool. So as you can see, that's pretty easy to do. We'll just jump back into CSS Hero, and if I want to change anything else, I can just collapse this down and go through and start doing other alterations. So let's just say, for example, I wanted to change the typography for the buttons. I can click and come in. I can change the color values. I can change the font, the weight, all those different good things. I've even got a font manager on here, so I can come through and I can choose my Google fonts. I can come through and choose Typekit fonts. Tons of options in there, so very easy to work with. So let's just close that down. If you want to change the background color, for example, we can do that as well. So I can change that from being the green color. Come in, I can choose from any predefined color. So let's just choose this blue. That's kind of now more in keeping with the style that we've got set up throughout the theme. And I'm not having to go and dig around inside my theme's control panel to go and find where the different values are for these different items. Which, when you've got a well-organized theme like Ocean WP, it's not too bad, but you can still find there are certain buttons, certain elements that if you're not sure where to find them, and as the theme grows, can kind of get a little bit sort of daunting how to find those, make those changes, and just update things. So something like this is pretty easy to work with and a lot easier than going through, like I say, digging through those things. So all the elements, anything that's on the page, I can simply come over, mouse over it, and you can see I've got the option to come in and control it. I can click on the text. It now comes in and shows me the options for the text. If I want to change the typography in there, spacing, all those kinds of good things. So this now gives us a ton more options on top of what our theme and what our page builder does. Now, while that's cool, it's also not that difficult to do, like you say, if you know a little bit of CSS code, but that's reliant upon things like OceanWP or your theme or Elementor Pro, allowing you to actually physically select and make changes to the various different parts of your page. But with something like CSS Hero, you're not reliant upon those. You can come in and you can just select something and do what you want with it. So for example, let's just say where we've got this block over on the right-hand side. We wanted to select that and put something around it. Put some margins in there, for example, or just sort of change a few things about it. Well, as long as we can come in and select it, we can now go in and make changes to it. So let's just say you want to put a border around that. Not that you'd want to, but you could do. So you can see we immediately put a border in there, so that's pretty cool. We've also got the ability there to come down. Obviously, the border's sitting a little bit close to that, so we can come into the padding, for example, and we can say, well, let's put some padding in there now. So we can come in, we can add some padding to the top. Let's put 10 pixels in there. 10 pixels in all of these. Just to come in and fine-tune. Okay. So, all very easy. Once we're happy, we can click on Save and Publish. Jump back onto our test page, refresh that, and there's our changes already in place. So you can see that we're not now reliant upon only having to deal with the theme and the options that are available in there. We can visually come in and adjust the layout of almost everything throughout the entire site. Pages, posts, comment sections, all those good things we can really come in and fine-tune and get something just a little bit more bespoke to what you can do. And that really is just scratching the surface of the power of what CSS Hero can do for you. Now, I know there are a number of options out there that are very similar to CSS Hero, and they do the same types of things. But I've got to be honest, I've used CSS Hero a few times now, and I've found it to just be really easy to work with, really intuitive. And if you are used to working with the customizer in WordPress, this is going to feel very natural. Now, if that sounds good to you, you may be thinking, well, that's all well and good, but what about if I'm using a mobile phone? What if I want to develop it and the CSS that I do in here kind of just makes things look a little bit rubbish when you move over to a different kind of device, different screen layout? Well, CSS Hero has you covered on that as well. If you take a look up in the top right-hand corner, you'll see we've got the editing mode option. And if we click in there, you can see we've got a range of different options for tablet landscape, mobile landscape, portrait, and so on. You've also got the media query manager. So you can come into here and you can see we can set up things like, where do we want those breakpoints to be? We have control over all those aspects as well. So again, that's pretty cool. We can control how the CSS that we apply to this is going to filter down through those different screen resolutions, screen sizes, and media devices. So that's pretty cool. I quite like that. What about if you're a bit of a power user that you like this sort of ability to select things, but you kind of want to get your hand stuck in there. You don't want to have to rely on this sort of left-hand panel to physically go in and find these different options. Well, you can do that as well. You can see that at the moment we're just working in the code editor alongside the properties inspector. Well, you can kind of go past that. If you want to, you can jump into the inspector, and you can see there's all the code that's being used. If we want to come in there, we can simply come in and start adding our own in there. So we might want to sort of put in margins, for example, and you can see it's a typical fully fledged code editor. So let's just say we put a 20 pixel margin in there. We can physically come in, type in what we want, save that out, and we don't have to rely upon this inspector kind of thing, you know, where we've got to go through and pick things and then manually go through and adjust those one selector at a time. We can do it either or both ways. So we can really speed up the process of working with any kind of style sheets that you want to create, edit, adjust visually or manually. So tons of options available in CSS Hero to give you a much more fine-tuned, streamlined process for customizing your sites above and beyond what you can do with your theme or your page builder. And that's kind of what I wanted to show you in this video. It's not a sponsored video. It was supplied free to me, but probably the best part of a year ago, and I'm really kind of going back and started testing it out in a lot more detail to see how easy it is to work alongside my new work process of using OceanWP or Astra alongside sort of Elementor Pro. And I find it's something that just gives me an infinite level of possibilities and control over those different things that the theme doesn't necessarily give me access to quite so easily. Well, the link for this is in the description below, alongside all the links to do with all the different products and things that we use on this channel. If you'd like to help support the channel, please consider using those links if you're thinking of purchasing any of the themes or plugins that we use. They're affiliate links and they give a small percentage back to the channel. It doesn't cost you any more money. Well, what do you think of CSS Hero? Do you think this is something you could put into your workflow? Do you have an alternative? Are you already using CSS Hero? Well, give us your feedback in the comments section below. I'd love to see and hear what you're using, how you're using it, and how you feel it benefits or degrades your process of creating websites with WordPress. As always, if you've got any comments, questions, or feedback on this video or anything else covered on the channel, please pop those in the comments section below. And don't forget to hit that like button. Hit the subscribe button, smash that bell icon to be notified as soon as we add new content to the channel. And as always, until next time, take care.